why did that catch me off guard? Oh my god. Because it's also just such a good
So everyone, Katrina has seen that the title of this episode we're about to watch is Ménage à Troi.
How could you record it?
You started laughing, so I started recording. I thought everyone might like to see your genuine initial reaction to the title of the episode.
Oh my god. A literal tear came up in my eye just now. Oh, my head kind of hurts. I need to drink some water. Holy fuck. Ménage. Oh. I love these motherfuckers. Holy shit. That was good. I'm going to take my TARDIS tea strainer out. This is the wrong show, but I don't care.
Close enough.
Take this out. Set it down.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
Whew, that was something.
Well, welcome everyone to the Gallifrey Gals Get Warped, the show where we watch Star Trek The Next Generation.
I've never seen it.
It's my favorite show.
Holy shit. I'm Katrina.
And we are about to watch season 3, episode 24.
Ménage à Troi. Holy fuck. So right off the bat, I'm like, okay, is there going to be a clone of her? Oh, good. You're awake.
Okay. Is there... Oh, good. The cats are awake.
Oh, good. Is there going to be a clone of her? Is it another holodeck involved episode? Is there multiple love interests? Can you back off my meatball? That's my meatball. Red sauce is going to make you sick.
I think it's mine, though.
It's acidic. It'll make you throw up. He had some tomato soup of mine one time, and it was an accident. That's when I learned. I looked it up. I was like, is this bad for cats? And they were like, some of them can just kind of handle it, and it's whatever, but a lot of cats will just vomit. And I'm like,
cool, good.
Within 20 minutes.
Yep.
I have nothing else. I'm trying to think. It's not that I forget the last three that we left off of. I just only remember the last one we left off of because it was so fucking good.
Oh yeah, Sarek.
Sarek, that was
the mind meld, Picard taking on all those emotions.
So good.
Before that was The Most Toys, where Data is kidnapped.
Ah, yes, there it is. Absolute dickhead.
And then the one before that was Hollow Pursuit, where we met Barclay.
Yep.
I don't know why I always call him Barclay. It's because that's how it's spelled. There's Barclay.
But yeah, and then broccoli. I think of broccoli. Yeah. Just so good. We're coming up on the end of the season, and it is just how it started. It's just like rolling out with bangers so far. It's been wild. Sarek was just like, I don't know. That felt like, I think I said it when we recorded it, but like I've felt like for a while now, I'm like, oh, I'm like a Trekkie. Like I'm definitely a fan of the show, but that one felt like it just like solidified.
Yeah.
Like it was just like.
Now you have a real connection to like Vulcan characters.
Yeah. It just felt very solidifying in the fact of like, oh yeah, I'm really into this fucking show. Yeah. So
yay.
I have three different versions of the
Enterprise.
Fantastic.
Yep. You're a nerd. It's official.
It's official.
Mine, see it, but it is. It's back. There.
I love you can't see it your at all. Lights. I know, but I love your whole setup. Like,
I just redid the lights, tried to make them look a little nicer.
Anyway, it looks so good.
Thanks. All right. Hey. I think we should watch this because we got some shit to get through today.
Yeah, let's do this.
So here we go. Ménage à Troi.
Captain's log, stardate 43930.7.
Loxana Troi, I desire you.
Yeah. What? What?
You see, your Betazoid skills would be very useful to me, and I find you very attractive.
Well, he's upfront about it.
I am willing to pay handsomely for you.
I don't think
it is. You must be aware that every female has her price.
Can you imagine that dreadful little creature talking to me like that? Doesn't he realize that I am the daughter of the fifth house of Beta Zed? Holder of the sacred chalice of Reeks. The sacred chalice of Reeks is an old clay pot with mold growing inside it.
Oh, well, perhaps one day when you're older and wiser, you'll understand.
Sit down.
And you even brought provisions.
That dress. She is.
Here, Will. Diana.
Oh my God.
Look at it. I'm very positive my mother owned a dress like that.
Yeah, right.
During her runway model days, I've definitely like.
Very tasty.
Ew.
So tell us, Loxana, the last time we met, you were looking for a husband. Have you had any luck?
Ah, alas, no. You had better beam back to your ship.
Returning to my ship is exactly what I had in mind.
With you.
Crater, transport 4 immediately.
No, Todd.
Dude's like, what? Back from the fairies, but.
So much for relaxing.
So much. No one ever gets there, surely.
No
one. Do you want me to become ill?
You must forgive the doctor. He is not accustomed to dealing with betazoid females. Now, Loxana, I have a business proposition for you.
Thanks, but I'm not interested in any of your propositions.
She's wrapped that fabric around her so fashionably.
She did it wonderfully.
It's like definitely like this little like 80s Barbie kind of look. Mm-hmm.
And now, Loxana Troi, let us talk.
Wouldn't do that.
I don't need your help.
The hell you don't. You're 2 moves away from being made it.
Get your poker face on and start fucking with him.
Yep.
Love it.
See? You should listen to me. That wasn't it.
I must admit, when you...
What?
First
her...
She said that was hideous, but I love it, actually.
Intrigue.
Well, no, it keeps
you mean
evolving.
Perhaps a little.
The dress has evolved. It was a piece of garment that is now...
Yes. She was like, he's giving me something perfectly
but
hideous to wear. Well, like,
it has straps now.
It could be a formidable team.
My. You have great strength in your hands.
I can't resist it. Then I don't. Oh, God. She's like, gross.
I do not trust you.
Fine. Thanks for the game.
You're like, all right, then I'll take my ball and go home.
So good.
Come out here.
Boop, boop, boop.
No one has ever given me umox like this before.
Umox?
There's no translation, but the ear is one of our most erogenous zones.
It's so gross to me. It's
jaws.
So gross.
Little one, if Tog were a kitten, he'd be purring. Good work, mother.
I knew you were not to be trusted.
Dr. Ferrick, I was just going to make Damon Tog a drink.
Save your lives for this fool.
But please don't listen to him. Don't. No, he's misunderstood.
No, Tog, you have misunderstood. Very well.
Oh.
Take her.
Oh.
Don't like it.
It's taking a turn.
Like this. Warp field phase adjustment. All this does is suppress the subspace interference generated by the warp engines.
Meaning what?
Meaning, if I set up a simple oscillation, I can send out a signal. The trick is to create a message that the Enterprise
will understand. Yeah, that it'll pick up.
The Ferengi will think is just normal subspace static.
Well, we have to help her.
Don't like it.
Thank
Thanks for your help, Wes, but you'd better get aboard the Bradbury. They were ready to break orbit an hour ago.
Soon as I'm sure this works.
What you thinking, Wes?
Captain,
right?
The Bradbury is hailing us. They can no longer delay their departure.
Mr. Crusher, now. No lengthy farewells. Good luck.
Thank you, sir. One of the signals was, I don't know, familiar somehow.
Something in the message?
No, the message was scrambled. It was the static.
Where are you going?
Wesley.
Wesley.
Captain, I think there's a pattern to the subspace interference I heard in one of the Ferengi messages.
Wesley, unless you leave immediately, you're gonna miss the Bradbury.
The interference itself could be a message. If I could just hear a replay of the subspace scans.
Tell me more.
In faith,
this is a pretty classic Picard meme.
With mine eyes, for they in thee a thousand errors see, but 'tis my heart that loves what they despise, who, in despite of view, art pleased to dote. Shall I
that one, yeah,
to a summer's day?
And you can't keep killing all my lovers. Now that simply
keep killing all my lovers.
Killing? Oh, is it safe and jealous?
Listen, Tog, I must possess Luaxana, and if that means destroying your ship in the process, so be it.
Captain, I had no idea Luaxana was...
Don't let him threaten you. You can defeat him.
But you...
Today.
But I thought you said I wasn't going to be able to go.
The Academy must make you wait, that's true. I hereby grant you field promotion to full ensign with all the commensurate responsibilities and privileges of that rank. Congratulations.
I'm fine.
You're dismissed.
She's fine.
We're fine.
We're not like super proud or anything.
Ensign Crusher, take us out of orbit. Set a course for Zamfras 3.
Course is set.
There are so many liquids.
There's a thing about this that I want to make sure I get right. Where? Oh gosh. Where is it?
Oh, I just trashed. Oh my god, my pants are just all wet.
Oh, here it is. Your pants are wet.
I've cried. It's just a puddle.
So apparently, when Wesley Crusher got this promotion, Gene Roddenberry gave Will Wheaton the second lieutenant bars that he earned in the Army Air Corps. And I guess that at that ceremony where he gave them to Will Wheaton, Colin Powell was there for that. Which is, I guess, just a nice thing to do for an actor that you're watching grow up on your show and their character gets a little promotion. And so you like mark it with this very cool thing. But I just thought that was kind of neat. So, yeah.
I love this fucking show so much.
So that's an interesting episode. It's got some silly things, got some creepy things.
Interesting, because I felt like it, I guess I should have maybe sort of expected it with the Ferengi being involved, because they normally have a little bit of a light, I don't want to say lighter, because it was fucked up, you know, like she was, you know, getting tortured and all of that, but like I was so nervous at the end, but then it was just such a comedic ending. It was just such a like comedic way to defeat the Ferengi in that situation.
To convince them that, like,
make them think that, you know, and
Patrick Stewart gets to do that silly and random Shakespeare.
So just like good.
Random like sonnets being pulled out.
He just is like yanking it out of nowhere. It was just so, it was so good. And so that felt really nice. And it was just like a nice, like fun kind of closure to it. No one was really hurt. Everything was, you know, like it's okay. I was worried about Wesley not like making it to that. Not being sad with him leaving. So of course, selfishly, I was like, yay. But then that at the end was like, no. It's so true. Everything he's done for the Enterprise is for his friends and his coworkers. Like, it's just all to think of that very first episode where Wesley is on the bridge.
He like gets in trouble for even just being on the bridge.
Being, like he just existing, like just breathing the same air as Picard.
And now he's in a full Starfleet uniform with his little ensign Pip. It's pretty cool.
I literally couldn't see the screen at the end because I was just crying so much. That was great. I'm real nervous about these last two episodes, but that was great. Yeah. I feel like that was a nice little like, oh, look at, we're towards the end of the season. Look how lovely this moment was. Oh, don't you love everyone? And now something really fucked up is about to happen. I can feel it in my bones.
Yeah, I don't know what you are talking about.
I can feel it in my bones and I need more tissues.
Well, I think we should watch those things and see how fucked up everything gets or doesn't get. She's scared, everyone. All right.
Okay.
Thanks, everyone, for watching. Are you scared? You should be.
No, they're all twisted and fucked up and excited to see what it's going to do to me. Because I get it, because that's how I am with Paula, with Doctor Who.
Yeah, you get a taste of your own medicine. Well, join your Gallifrey gals next time as we continue to boldly watch what no noob has ever watched before.
We appreciate you. Thank you so much.
We do.
Yeah, thanks for joining us on this journey. Like, subscribe, stay notified, and check us out on patreon.com/GallifreyGals. Be a part of our Discord, talk with us, send us fan mail. We just posted our PO box. All kinds of fun things. Love y'all.
We love y'all. Bye. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching. If you liked this video, go ahead and give it a little thumbs up. And if you want to be notified when we post new content, go ahead and subscribe to our channel and hit that little bell in the corner.